because, as you know, this marks the kickoff of a very special week. Special week for Michael Jackson, special week for Pepsi-Cola, and a very special week for New York City. Tomorrow night, the Grammy Awards return here for the first time in 7 years. And the following night, Michael Jackson gives his first ever solo concert in this city. I'm happy to say that Pepsi will play a major role in each of these events, the Jackson family. Michael and his brothers would make 2 Pepsi commercials, and we would sponsor the victory tour. Well, that tour set records for ticket sales, made headlines around the globe, and the Pepsi commercials, brothers helped drive Pepsi awareness to all-time highs, propelled sales to record levels, and provided a burst of momentum that we're still running on 4 years later. And as for the Cola Wars, well, I think once Michael joined us, I think it's fair to say that what had long been one of the most visible competitions in the world immediately became among the most entertaining, as one way we could possibly top the first. Really, only one change we could make that would please his millions of fans even more than the originals did. And that was to put a little bit more of Michael into the advertising. More of him singing.
Thank you very much. I'm very honored, very thankful. I love you all. Thank you.
We'd like to bring out Christopher Eddeley, the president of the United Negro College Fund, now for a special presentation. Chris? Chris, on behalf of Michael and the Pepsi-Cola Company and all the many supporters of the United Negro College Fund, present the proceeds of the benefit concert that Pepsi and Michael will do Thursday night in the amount of $600,000 to the United Negro College Fund. All right? You got it? Okay. Let's go around this way. Come on. Let's...
Financial support. In fact, over 90% of them require scholarship aid to get through college. And I am just so grateful. I am just so grateful to Pepsi-Cola and to Michael for their largesse, their generosity in providing these $600,000 to the United Negro College Fund. Pepsi-Cola's support for the United Negro College Fund goes back to 1945. And in 1981, Pepsi-Cola was the first company to step forward and make a $1 million pledge to the United Negro College Fund. And in the last 3 years, more than 97 students have received those scholarships. And you know, Michael reads the names of every student and why that student gets the people. The College Fund is so grateful to you, to Roger Enrico, to Pepsi-Cola. Thank you very much.
Now, there's one last item, Michael. If those of you in the press who cover Thursday night's concert, when you're there, you're going to see something you've never seen before. Because every one of the best seats in the house, the ones closest to the stage, will be filled by special youngsters, compliments of Pepsi and Michael. 1,000 of those youngsters will be 179 in Brooklyn. Come on, meet your friend here. Okay? Come on, let's say hello.
Can we get them over here?
Okay, we're gonna have them read their things first, and then we'll do a photo. All right? Go ahead.
Dear Michael, count me in. I want everybody in my school to be against drugs, and here's how we can do it. Lectures in school about drug abuse and the ill effects it has on our lives. Kids must remember, crack will set you back, with pills you'll be downhill, and cocaine is insane.
Frank Lopez. My message to Michael. Drugs is a dirty word in my vocabulary. I want my life to be like a run-on sentence filled with many commas and exclamation points, not to end with a question.
I'm Jamie Epstein. My message to Michael Jackson is, if everybody could have...
You're right, Michael.
Now for Richard Corbin.
Like this side again, please.
Okay, want to do one more on this side? Okay, we'd like to thank you all for being with you.
Let's go.
The Grammy for Album of the Year goes to the artists and album producers. The nominees are...
Bass, Michael Jackson. Album producers Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson.
Sign of the Times, Prince. Album producer, Prince.
Trio, Dolly Parton, Linda Ronstadt, and Emmy Lou Harris. Album producer, George Massenberg. Whitney Houston, album producer, Garada Michael Walden.
Well, this is all very Celtic, we appreciate it. It's actually, really is hard carrying the weight of the world on your shoulders and saving the whale and organizing summits between world leaders and that sort of thing. But we enjoy our work and... it's hard when there's 50 million people or so watching not to take the opportunity to talk about things like South Africa and what's happening there and remarkable people like Bishop Tutu and what they have to put up with. But tonight is maybe not the night for me to do that, so I'll instead just, I'd like to talk about the music, as we set out to make music, soul music. That's what you two wanted to make. To us, soul music's not about being black or white, or the instruments you play, or whether you use a drum machine or not. It's a decision to reveal or conceal, and without it, people like Prince would be nothing more than a brilliant song and dance man that he is, but he's much more than that. People like Bruce Springsteen would be nothing more than, he would be nothing more than a great storyteller, but he's much more than that. Without it, you two would probably be getting better reviews in the Village Voice, but that's a joke. Sometimes they don't understand. Without it, you two certainly wouldn't be here, and we are here, and I wouldn't want to be anywhere else than New York City tonight. Thank you.
Producer of the Year goes to a record producer for outstanding creativity in a representative body of work released during the eligibility year. And here are the nominees. You see, you'll
be my knight in shining. Emilio and the Jerks. Quincy Jones. Sorry. Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson. I was in a hurry. Daniel Lanois. Brian Angel. That's when sports spoke. John Mellencamp and Don Gaiman. Noriyuki Michael Walden.
And the producer of the year is Noriyuki Michael Walden.
How you like me now? It is such an honor to win this. There's so many great performers and people who've won this. I just want to thank a few people so I won't forget. I have a very dear grandmother I want to dedicate this to. Alex and Nellie Booker, my grandparents. Along the way, there's been a very dear man who's inspired me spiritually. His name is Sri Chinmoy. I want to dedicate this to him as well. My management, David Rubinson, Greg DeJoven, my beautiful wife, Anukampa. Thank you, dear. Thank you. All the great artists who helped me, all the great producers along the way. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All my love.
Announce the best R&B vocal performance male, we would like to recognize the winners in the R&B field that were awarded just prior to airtime. They are
Best R&B Vocal Female, Aretha Franklin. Yeah. Best R&B Vocal Performance Duo or Group with Vocal, I Knew You Were Waiting for Me, Aretha Franklin and George Michael. Yeah. Best R&B Instrumental, Chicago Song, David Sanford. And the Best Rhythm and Blues Song, Lean On Me, Bill Withers.
The nominees for Best R&B Vocal Performance Male are Bad, the single. Bad, the single, Michael Jackson. In the Midnight Hour, Wilson Pickett. Just to see her, Smokey Robinson. Just to hold, don't say you love me. When it's my heart, you're breaking. Live, Jonathan Butler. Wish I could have seen a skeleton in your closet. Skeleton, Stevie Wonder.
And the winner is...
I can't wait. Hurry up. Oh, my God.
Just to see her, Smokey Robinson. He couldn't be here tonight, and we accept the Grammy on his behalf.
マイケル・ジャクソンがニューヨークにやってまいりました。マンハッタンもさすがにマイケルブームが巻き起こっております。私今マジソンスクエアガーデンの前に来ておりますけれども、このマンモス会場で3日間にわたって公演が行われます。私も切符をしっかりと持ってやってまいりました。ここはあと45分ぐらいでニューヨークの初日の幕が開きますマジソンスクエアガーデンの中です。前列の一番いいところには施設から招かれた子どもたちが陣取っております。 How do you feel about Michael Jackson?
I don't know, he's cute.
The world's best known Irishmen were among the many who paid a visit backstage.
Thank you.
Pepsi, the next stop was New York with three sold-out shows.
New York! New York, buddy! Just like I pictured it!
Shows at Madison Square Garden, and the first night was certainly star-studded, and Michael reserved the best seats in the house for underprivileged...
I promise I will never ever be returning. When my baby broke my heart and left me, ooh, as we walked into the room, there was faces stand there and telling through me.
Months ago, he had a top five single in Spain, in Italy, in Germany, in Holland. So he still has a fairly huge and sizable fan base outside the United States.
Now, you mentioned a couple very key obstacles ahead of Michael Jackson's career. If he does want to stage a world tour, does want to stage a comeback, you talked about his age, you talked about those child molestation charges. Even though he's been acquitted, those will still continue to haunt him. But what about the fact that he is living a peculiar lifestyle? The Neverland Ranch, the Bubbles the Chimpanzee, all of that. Does that make him even harder to market?
Well, the first thing he has to do...
It was a snazzy show, all right, with a strutting, confident Michael Jackson demonstrating that if not exactly bad, he could be naughty. In this tour of 88, we're seeing a new Michael Jackson, no longer as fragile as he once appeared on stage. This new, more adult Jackson has come of age in the age of rock and roll.
での公演は3月の7日に終わりましたが、前別ツアーの後はヨーロッパツアーが待ち構えています。そしてその後、マイケルは再度日本を訪れたいという強い希望を持っていると聞きました。このマンモス会場で3日間にわたって公演が行われます。私も切符をしっかりと持ってやってまいりました。 ニューヨークが実現して、もう一度日本にやってくるということになれば楽しみですね。
proceeds from the concert went to the United Negro College Fund.
Of three sold-out nights at the Garden benefited the United Negro College Fund, and clearly one of the many highlights was an encore of Grammy Night's mesmerizing Man in the Mirror. Despite coming up empty at the Grammys, Michael Jackson had the audience rocking in the aisles, and he was up to the task again last night at a hot benefit concert in New York. Jackson's electrifying appearance at the Grammy Awards made an already excited crowd at Madison Square Garden even more so.
He's terrific.
The best song I like about Michael when he rocked at ABC, so that was hot.
Nah, the Man in the Mirror is better.
He puts on a show, doesn't he? Jackson will perform two more sold-out concerts in New York this weekend and pull up stakes for a move to St. Louis, where he's opening next Saturday. Great.
How many times do you think they did that? That's all for now. Join Mary Hart and me on Monday. We'll take you behind the scenes with Tom Selleck for the final episode of Magnum P.I.
And we're going to leave you for the weekend with more of the bad man himself. Michael Jackson sings Just Another Part of Me. See you later.
Have a great weekend.
Hotel.
I'm